And welcome back to Dungeon Hack. In the last episode, we met what is probably our most formidable foe to date, and that is the Wraith. The Wraith is an asshole, because when he hits you, he has a chance of draining a level of experience and making you lose all your spells. All of your memorized spells. But I have a plan for dealing with the Wraith. That involves dancing around him like a madman, saving after each wraith I kill, and not letting him hit me, basically. I'm going to be using distance attacks only. No hand-to-hand combat with any wraiths. I just can't risk getting hit by one. Did I kill it? Yes. Time to save again. This may seem tedious, but trust me, it is way better than the alternative. The alternative being loading our game after every time we lose a level of experience, which takes 10 times longer than saving does. And yet another ring. We don't have three hands, so that's going to have to wait until we get an identify mirror and we can figure out what some of this shit does. Wraith! Now why did it go to the camp? I didn't click that. I clicked my hammer. That got him. I really wish we didn't have to resort to basically save stating my way through it, but you gotta do what you gotta do, you know? Crap. Oh my god, there are like three wraiths in that room. Let's see if I can lure them through the teleporter. No. Okay, let's try this other direction. Crap! It was a close one. We almost got hit. Did I kill him? Whoa! Level 8. 10 more hit points. Very nice. Let's see what new spells we get. See, we have another 4th level spell available, so I will get another Cure Serious, another 3rd level. We don't need Create Food and Water. I'm just going to get... I think Prayer does something good. I forget. I need to check the manual. I need to check the manual about a lot of stuff. I don't know, maybe it even protects me against, maybe one of these spells protects me against level drain. Do I have any, nope, no 5th level spells yet. Okay, actually, you know what? I'm going to pause the game right now, or pause the recording right now, and I'm just going to read the manual. I want to see what these spells do and see if any of them help me. So, BRB. And we're back. I just learned something quite useful indeed. The spell that I had no idea what it does, called Negative Plane Protection, that protects you against level drain. I'm not sure what that has to do with anything, but what that has to do with negative planes, but I'm not going to argue. I'm just going to cast the damn thing. And you can see that we're affected by the spell because we have that border around us. I'm not sure if it completely protects us from that, or if it only partially protects us from that. Well, the manual says it partially protects us from that, but I think what it might have meant... Oh, great. It's only good for one hit? You've got to be kidding me. And as a bonus, it also does damage to the Wraith when it hits me. I've probably been calling that thing a White and a Wraith interchangeably, because I always get those two confused for some reason. Well, they're both undead creatures beginning with W, so you can see how that would be confusing. But from the looks of it, every time if I have a negative plane protection, it's guaranteed to protect me from a hit, at least. And there are probably some other defensive spells that I could be casting, like Bless and Prayer. I'll get to those in a bit. Remember, kids, when in doubt, read the manual. That shit's helpful. It's not just for copy protection anymore. Also, something that I was wondering about, the remove paralysis spell. I thought it was silly because, you know, if you're paralyzed, you can't use magic, but it also removes the slow effect and also the hold effect, which I think in some cases you still have the ability to act if you're held. Good gravy. Do your worst, monsters. I am ready. Wait, no, I'm not. I'm not ready at all. Dude, where'd my hammer go? Oh, there it is. This is a long freaking hallway. Jesus Christ. I threw my hammer and it took like 30 seconds for it to come back. And we still have the negative plane protection. It has a pretty decent duration, it looks like. Have we exhausted all the possibilities here? Yeah, it looks like it. Unless there's a secret door somewhere, which there probably is somewhere in that hideously long hallway. I better check just to be on the safe side. I really wish there was a more efficient way of checking for secret passages than that, but there's not. Eat a dick, Wraith. Eat a big, hairy dick. Okay, so we teleported back, and we're ready to continue with the dungeon proper. Well, it's all the dungeon proper. A stone key and a ruby. Okay, there has to be another secret exit around here somewhere. It takes us back up. Which ways have we explored? Let's see. Okay, I didn't check the left branch of that hallway. That's probably where the secret is. Because there's gotta be one around here somewhere. Am I in the right place? Yep. See, what did I tell you? Horrible direction sense. Alright, let's see what we have here. No secrets. Well, slap my ass and call me Debbie. Is there another teleporter here somewhere? Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's that one teleporter that leads me to a room full of wraiths. Oh, God. That's the way I have to go. There's no other way. Well, let's rest first. Negative flame protection. Spiritual hammer. Flame blade. Save game. Tune in next time when I take on the Room of Wraiths. This should be pretty suicidal. See you later.